Hello Bournemouth fans, hope you are well. This is a bit of a different video on the channel. We're less than a week away before the playoffs and Brentford in the first leg. Yes, a tough game that will be, and plenty of content coming your way before that fixture, during and after. But today, I will be trying to stay fit. And we have some of the AFC Bournemouth Cherries Red Army community coming together and back of the net to have a kick around at Little Down, six aside, and there will be a certain club legend playing as well. Make sure you stay tuned for that. I'm a bit worried. I did roll my ankle playing the other evening and it is a bit tender, but I'm going to get myself out there, get it strapped up, because I'm not missing out on this. Enjoy the video. Up the Cherries. Okay, so I've had my pre-match lunch to get energy in my system before tonight's game, and we've kept the lineups under wraps because there is a certain former AFC Bournemouth player that is contributing on the pitch tonight, and I'm just about to break the news to one of our players, see how he takes it. Should we give him a call? Let's do it.
Hello.
Steve Hensman, how you doing?
Ah, Mr. T, how are you?
Not too bad. Fighting fit tonight. You were injury-free, ready for the game?
Well, as bad as injury-free as a 43-year-old can be. A few aches and pains, but nothing untoward.
So I finally got round to drawing up the teams. We're going to be in team black shirts tonight. So we've got Mark Davies in goal, yourself at the back with Chris. I'll play in the middle with Sam Davies and Tom Jordan up top. Are you happy with that?
Yeah, that's pretty good, isn't it? It's pretty decent.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah,
I might have to carry him a bit in the midfield. You never know. The opposition, then, they're team white shirts tonight. We've got Chris in goal for them, Sean and Potts. Jaden will also be playing, and Marc McAdam and Marc Pugh.
Hello.
Marc McAdam.
And who was the other one?
Marc Pugh.
Marc
Pugh.
Marc Pugh.
There's only one Marc Pugh.
Laugh, aren't you?
We got him on a pay-as-you-play deal, so we drafted it in. We're not sure how many games we'll get out of him, but I thought I'd pre-warn you, so I want you to rest up.
He's going to have me on my arse most of the game.
Well, that's the plan, and if he does chop you, we won't let you forget it.
Unbelievable scenes.
Right, and I'll see you in a few hours then, buddy.
I'm looking forward to it. Can't
Excellent.
Believe that. Nice one. See you later, bud.
Catch you later, mate.
Bye.
He is going to be screwed. One more phone call to make then to the club captain, team captain, Sam Davies. Let's see if he's ready. How you doing, Sam? How you doing, mate?
Yeah, very good, mate. How are you?
Not too bad. I just broke the news to our central defender, Steve. I know we kept it under wraps about Marc Pugh. He now knows he's going up against him.
Oh, my God. What were his thoughts?
He couldn't believe it to start with, and now I think he's crapping himself a bit.
I've heard rumours of rainbow flicks recently, so he's got to be aware of that.
I can't wait. I've already got a clip ready for him if he gets chopped. So team captain then tonight, Sam, I'm going to play in the middle with you.
Excellent.
I'm a bit worried that your relentless Little Down championship season, this will be your third game in a row. Are you still fit?
Last night, it was super. I mean, I wouldn't exactly call myself fit, but certainly raring to go anyway, buddy.
Excellent. Are you marking Marc McAdam tonight?
I will take McAdam, happy to leave you and Steve to deal with Pughy, no problem at all. You can double up on him, that's fine by me.
Fantastic. I'll pick up the pieces then, and let's hope we can get some decent balls up to Tom Jordan.
Yeah, hoping for 3 points, mate.
Let's go for it. I'll catch you in a few hours, buddy.
Cheers. See you, mate. Bye.
Cheers, bye.
Captain's ready. Let's do it.
like a pill that I just can't trust. You told me to stop, but I keep on going. Told me to stop, but I keep on going. Told me to stop, but I keep on going. Keep on, keep on, keep on. You'll never stop this. Did I move too far? It's all too much. I think I must be mad to give you everything I had, everything I had, everything, everything, but it still went bad. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Keep on, keep on, keep on. You'll never stop this thing.
Sam Davies, how you doing, Sam?
Hello, mate. Yeah, I found that hard work. The, like, everything below my knees really, really hurt, but it was a good game. I really enjoyed it.
We started really well, but did those three games in a row catch up with you eventually?
Yeah, I played on Sunday night, Monday night, and then today. But I was really, you know, I was always excited about the one tonight. Hard work, the adrenaline was pumping. I played in fits and starts. When I was stood still, my legs hurt, but when I ran, I glided, it's fine. So yeah, it's good.
Three goals last night, but you did stick the ball away in this one tonight as well. So you catch
twice, and an assist for someone as well, so yeah, I was happy with that.
And what about Marc Pugh, playing against him? He hasn't lost it, has he?
Great player, mate. Just the touch, the awareness, the tenacity. He keeps on going for the ball, you think he's gone, and like, yeah, he's amazing, mate. He's amazing.
Thoughts on Brentford, first leg, Monday, early thoughts?
I'm now on your camp, but then it's because I have to be. We've always got those matches where these individual decisions can make it seem like an injustice come the end. Brentford, we've got 180 minutes. If in the first game we get a player sent off or we get some kind of incident happening, then we can turn it around. We've still got time. So I'm on your side now in terms of how it's going to be. And, you know, look, if they beat us over 180 minutes, they deserve to go through. And there's no injustice. We completely deserve it. So, yeah.
So that's one person from the back of the net panel four to go to turn my way before Monday.
Yeah, Tom's next as well. So
let's get Tom in as well. Tom's it. Carrying a few injuries now. Groin didn't hold up eventually. Went in goal. Beat in, let yourself down in goal. Bit of a Asmobegovic.
I thought it was the cat, actually. Yeah, I was quite impressed with my performance. I've got a Marc Pugh war wound, so I'm happy. But yeah, I wasn't sure. Probably wasn't fully fit, but when you hear Marc Pugh's playing, got a tan up on you, but I really enjoyed it. Really enjoyed it.
Got any quick player ratings for us, Sam?
I thought Sammy put a shift in. Put a good shift. Sometimes decision making at times, you know. But you know what Sam Davies is like. He's better behind the camera than he is on the pitch. But when he saw the camera in the distance, I thought he turned on a little bit. But now Sam's a good player. Steve Hensman for me, absolute rock at the back for me. When I went in goal, when I've got Hensman in front of me, you just feel safe. You feel safe with Hensman there. So, everyone knows Steve Hensman, and he was top draw tonight. But, yeah, really enjoyed it. It was good standard tonight, I thought. Really good performances.
And finally, Marc Pugh, club legend. What an absolute dream to watch.
I thought he kept up with us quite well. No, Marc's, he's class, isn't he? Absolutely brilliant. But he does even, you know, you know he can do whatever he wants, but he still does it simple so well. You don't know where he's going. There was a few times, I think it might have been on you, where he's like, you just don't know which way he's going to go. Class bloke, and he'll still be a... If he goes to play for someone else, he'll be brilliant for him, won't he? You know he will.
And let's get Steve Hensman, the centre-back for Cherries Red Army's team tonight.
Just going to introduce him with the Man of the Match award as well.
Thank you very much, Tom.
There you go.
Absolute super.
A Budweiser there for the Man of the Match. I think you just about dealt with Marc Pugh in the end.
Well, he had me on toast a couple of times, I must admit, but... I don't know, I feel like I did myself proud. I thought it was going to be a long night, but it wasn't so bad.
I never thought I'd see you not win a header, but there was the old one that came in from a corner. You did have a leap, but you were just slightly off it, but you were a monster at the back there.
Well, the problem was I was let down by my midfielders. I was the only one defending at times, so I don't know what happened to you boys. A few little injuries knocking about.
Got Marc Pugh, the legend, club legend of AFC Bournemouth, and Mark McAdam, Sky Sports legend. How are we doing, guys?
Yeah, good, thanks, yourself. It's always better when you win.
How you doing, Mark?
All good, yeah. A bit tired after that.
I think it goes to show tonight that Pughy can still play at the highest level.
He can definitely still play at the highest level. I think I've been acting as his unofficial agent for the last 2 or 3 years, but I haven't quite got him the movie he deserves. But this summer, I'm sure you'll get the exclusive when he gets a big club again.
That fitness and nutrition came through in the end?
Yeah, it came through in the end. I think we pushed on towards the end and... it was a good game. It was a good game. I think you went 5-4 up. And then quality showed in the end.
Fitness definitely told in the end. And while we've got you here, we can't ask about the playoffs. Mark, Brentford coming up on Monday. I mean, your early thoughts on the first leg?
I think it's going to be a huge challenge. I think, you know, what you've got in Brentford and Bournemouth are two of the most exciting teams in the Championship. Two teams that got a lot of individual quality. They play the right way. And you know, both teams have had good, successful recent periods in their history. You know, Brentford getting promoted to the Championship, what Thomas Frank's done, the way they've adapted to the level, the fact they got into the playoffs and got so close last season to getting promoted, and of course missing out on automatic promotion on the final day of the season. And they've got exciting players, whereas Bournemouth have been in the Premier League, they've got players that have played at the highest level. So I think it's set up perfectly to be a really exciting Championship semi. Over both legs, and it's one of those games that's brilliant because you genuinely can't call it because both teams are so good.
Three games without a win, three games without a goal. We haven't beaten Brentford yet this season. We're due a win against them, aren't we, Pugh?
Definitely. I think form goes out the window in the playoffs. It's a lottery. It's whoever turns up on the day, home and away. We haven't beaten Brentford yet. It's going to be a real tough ask, but both teams are full of quality, like Mark touched on there. And I think it's set up for a great tie, and anything can happen. And I think if Bournemouth's quality in the final third short, then they can score plenty of goals on the day.
Looking forward to it. A few weeks to go then, Mark. Going to be busy?
Yeah, well, I think the playoffs are always a busy time. It's always an exciting time. It's the climax of 10 months of hard work and graft from teams in the EFL, the ones that have managed to sneak into the playoffs, and they'll all be excited about having the end to the season they all want. So this period of time is always exciting. We've still got the end of the Premier League, and the summer's exciting with the European Championships, the Olympics around the corner, and of course Bournemouth hopefully preparing a team to be operating in the top flight as opposed to the Championship. So it's going to be an interesting few weeks, that's for sure.
And I know you'll be supporting Bournemouth in the next couple of weeks, Mark, but looking forward to where your next move might be.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. I've had a bit of time away from football now. Recharge the batteries, as they say, and looking forward to what comes next. And like I say, I've been enjoying the five-a-sides twice a week to keep myself fit, so really looking forward to what's around the corner.
Highlight of my year so far. Thank you guys for joining us. Good six aside. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and also like as well. The Cherries are on their way to the playoffs. Can we make it? Let's hope so. Till next video, up the Cherries.